everyone, and as always, welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you can see, you know, I am out here on the walk with my family's dog, Maddie. The pooch now, looking around, sniffing around, checking things out, and I apologize for the siren in the background. I'm guessing it's a fire truck or something rather. But yeah, there she is, enjoying the walk outdoors. On to today's content. So of course, the most recent piece of news coming out today is that former mayor and the host of his namesake tabloid talk show, Jerry Springer, has died. Now, for most people growing up in the 90s, they remember him from his namesake tabloid talk show, The Jerry Springer Show, where, you know, Springer pretty much, you know, focused on just some of the most outrageous, outlandish, you know, society issues of that area. From drag queens to transgendered people, you know, you name it, Springer covered it. Now, of course, quite a lot of people, especially in the LGBT community, haven't had very fond memories of Springer simply because of the fact of, well, his talk show more or less getting a laugh, getting ratings and viewership at the expense of, you know, stuff like drag queens and transgendered people back when that kind of stuff more or less wasn't exactly tolerated by society. But yeah, so Jerry Springer has died. And of course, a lot of people on social media are talking about him, Judge Judy, and Bob Barker being inducted into some like, some kind of like a fictional sick day Hall of Fame. As that's what a lot of kids, you know, back in the 90s when they, you know, stayed home sick from school, that was the kind of programming that they watched. And of course, quite the big news topic coming out of the last few days, Fox News Channel and Tucker Carlson have parted ways. Now, originally, Fox News didn't really provide, you know, any bit of, you know, an explanation as to why Carlson was fired. Some people have said it's likely because of, and I apologize for the change in the brightness here, but some people speculate it was because of the settlement for the Dominion lawsuit. Others allege that it was because of a lawsuit that a former Fox producer filed against Carlson. I mean, honestly, we'll never know the true reasoning for Tucker Carlson's departure from Fox News. And of course, in the aftermath of Carlson's departure from Fox News, it's been pointed out by a lot of rightists that the stock price for Fox Corporation has tumbled quite a bit. So it seemed that even Donald Trump supporters And again, I apologize for the siren. It's in that that now even Donald Trump supporters are turning on Fox News because of the firing of Tucker Carlson. Much, quite a lot of stuff that's gone on recently. And another news topic that actually just happened across my mind just now. So apparently, in the ongoing feud between the Walt Disney Company and Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, it would apparently seem that Disney is now at the point where they are actually filing suit against DeSantis for, you know, his, specially appointed board basically trying to punish Disney for standing up against, you know, Florida's Don't Say Gay law that the Florida GOP recently, you know, pushed through the state Congress. I mean, I know, just from looking at things, I wouldn't be surprised if it turns out that this whole thing between Disney and DeSantis eventually ends with an outright Disney victory. I mean, as Disney has pointed out, they were in Florida long before DeSantis became governor, and they will remain in Florida long after DeSantis is term limited out of office. Because I believe at the end of this term, Ron DeSantis, according to the Florida Constitution, will be ineligible for re-election ever again as governor of Florida. And it seems like when it comes to social media, Twitter especially, it seems like things are just getting worse and worse for Elon Musk. Because now, it's the situation, I apologize, my voice becomes kind of hard to hear a bit because of the blowing wind. Elon Musk has taken it upon himself to, I guess, gift blue check marks to certain well-followed celebrities on Twitter. The problem is, what that blue check mark entails is implying that the person who has gotten it, even if they haven't paid for it, implies that they have subscribed to Twitter Blue. Now, a lot of people have raked Musk over the coals for that whole situation, simply because of the fact that with what Musk is doing, you know, basically falsely claiming somebody is paying for whatever is actually against the law. Musk could actually get in very big, Musk and Twitter could actually get in very big legal trouble for deceptive practices like that. And as I've told lots of people on social media, it would not surprise me one bit if it turns out that before this year, 2023, is over with, so is Elon Musk's control of Twitter. The fact that the stuff he's done, what he's allowed to be posting on Twitter, is continually driving away advertisers, and the fact that the European Data Protection Board has directly stated that if Musk doesn't start improving Twitter's content moderation policies, they will be forced to take legal action against him. So, I don't know, it just seems like that things are just not going too well for Elon Musk. But then again, he put himself into the whole situation, so it's his own fault. So, I guess that is about it for this video. As always, I would like to thank all of you out there for tuning into my YouTube channel and for watching this here video. So, until next time, and, you know, in remembrance of Jerry Springer, take care of yourselves and each other, and until next time, as I usually say right about now, have a great day, everyone.